Hello, welcome everybody. Welcome to Astral Studio, and this is Anuja Pandey. Today we are in our workshop day 9. So we will be we have done actually 8 workshops before. They were all live workshops, and if you have not checked those, please check it. So in Astral Studio, we do workshops on folk arts and share a lot of information about the origin, history, why we do this art, and the manner in which we have to do this art. So connecting with this, do subscribe the channel if you have not subscribed, and press the notification bell icon so that you do not miss on to any of the workshops. And yes, we have done a lot many things in the Pichhwai workshop. This is our after a lot of tribals and the folk arts, this is our Pichhwai workshop, and many of you have joined us new. So I welcome everybody. And today we will talk about Pichhwai. As we have done the elements, we will be doing the figures. Pichhwai is not all about the animals. Yes, there are few animals which are very, very common in that. And like cow and peacocks, birds, and the scenery is very, very beautiful. So you will see a lot of flora and fauna, plus you will see the local folks. And even if we see our Krishna, the Krishna is also with the gopis and with other people. So he is also a folk person in that setting. There are a few other paintings which are considered as Pichhwai only is known for Shrinathji picture. That's wrong. Shrinathji is a very, very important aspect and very important subject, or the main Pichhwai revolves around life of Krishna. So that is the idol that we make. But we also make the figure form, the human form of the god among with all the gopis. So today we will study about the human anatomy and how to make the figures, how to make the body proportions and how the faces. So we will talk about that. And coming to, hello everyone, sorry I just missed all the hellos that you have typed in. Feel welcomed here. Hello everyone. And today we will be doing the figure of a female. When I say female, it comes to a vision that in Pichhwai mostly it will be Radha. So Radha and other females, there's not much difference in it. It is just that Radha is the closest to Krishna. If in case it is with Krishna, it will be closest to Krishna, and then we say that is Radha. But we see similarity in lot of the females, and the profile is very strict profile. Strict profile, if I say, all the figures will be just half in the sense the body you may see half or full, but the faces will be turning to this side, so you will have only the side profile of the face. Parva Pandey, hello ma'am, I have a question about the painting of maybe Nataraj behind you. Can you please show that? Sure, that is a very big Tanjore painting. I'll show you. Yeah, it's like the background is not very clear right now. So I will definitely show you. That is on my Instagram also. Please visit it so that you can see more work that I do. If you want to connect to me personally, you can check there also. There are a lot many workshops, and workshops what we are doing in the YouTube are the folk arts first. We will definitely extend it as many have requested on different art forms. We will do that, but slowly we will start one after the other. So coming to the figure, when we talk about a female figure, it is anatomically, it has to be very, very proportionate. And this is not like the tribal arts where we can just take the symbols or the forms. Here in Pichhwai, we do very realistic, very, very realistic, I would not say, but yes, very close to realistic. And the forms are very natural. So pleasant looking, and they are not abstract, they are not symbols, they are straight, just as we see humans. It is that the dressing depict the culture of Rajasthan. So there is always a odhni. In English we call it scarf or whatever it can be said, but in Indian culture it is called odhni, generally worn by a choli, which is a blouse and a ghagra. So lehenga, the blouse, and the odhni, that is the covering cloth. So that is seen. How do we draw this? First, whenever I'll just take up the question. If you have any questions, please type in. I will take it after the talk. Okay, so if we talk about the dressing, this is as I discussed, it depicts the Rajasthani form. Now in various there is a small shift from Pichhwai, and there we start seeing the amalgamation towards the miniature, or the from Rajput style of painting also gets in. And then Pichhwai is influenced by the Rajput style and then the Mughal style. This all happened over a period of time when the whole region was such rich in culture, was actually taken up by the Mughals. So the art was influenced by a lot of Mughal elements as well later on, but not the Pichhwai. This is a very close connection, means they share the same boundary, I would say. So there is very small, and there whenever there is a transition from one art to the other, we see the few paintings which have both the features. So that is a cultural amalgamation that happened over a period of time. So I will be using the stuff here. I will place it on my table and adjust the camera. Just give it to me a moment. Okay, I hope you are able to see this. Okay, now I'm just taking a regular paper because this is the paper where I will be talking about a lot of shapes that are there to give you a proper understanding of how to make the faces in the side profile. So you just need a paper, a pencil, any pencil. This is cedar wood pencil, just a HB, 2 HB pencil, an eraser which you would need actually, and for finer details the 0.5 pencil, mechanical pencil. So this is a rough sheet. Later I will be drawing one full figure to show you how it applies. So how we determine the face, we will be doing the face study, and later on I will be telling you about the body. Here, so whenever we chalk out the face, if this is the portion where I'm doing the face, I hope the angle is correct. Wait a minute. Yeah, much better now. So the face is in a side profile. So just take this. And when we see the face, it is not always straight. So if you take a straight line, this happens most of the time when I check the work of my students, this happens most of the time. They take the face as this profile. Do not take the face as this. It has to have this curve, because our face is in a kind of a first a sphere, and then it takes the, this is the chin part and this. So this sphere is always there, right? So here I'm taking this. Sorry, I'm just a little too close to my here, so I'll erase it. Don't take this one. So it's like this curve. I'm drawing it dark so that it's visible to you. I recommend you make it very light, because these are just the guidelines. Now the head will be just circular, so just see that this portion is a circle, is a small section of the circle. So this is supposed to be your face, this shape. It is the basic. When you draw your pictures, you have to break your picture into basic shapes. So we got this idea, and now starting the picture. It's a small, soft curved Now, this portion, whatever you take, has to be divided into three parts. How would you just determine it? I'll just go one more step. So you have to divide it into three equal parts. This is called the rule of the one-thirds. Here, here, and here. So I'm dividing this portion into three parts. Here is where the nose will start. Finish the curve. And giving a nostril and this. Generally, the noses are very pointed and beautiful, if I may say. So all the features are very, very soft. They are not harsh or anything. Now I'm falling myself in the criteria of this. And this is the easiest way of making this portion. So here in the two portions out of this, this is the forehead, one portion covers by the nose and the other is here. Now I'm making the eye. Make a little petal shape eye, a small leaf shape eye. Eyelid. This way. Now there is a softness that is created in these pictures. I will give you a little bit of shade work as well, so you will relate to the colors also how we do it. If you give the color or the shade to the nose, it seems to be pointed, otherwise it looks very broad. I'll just erase all these line work that I have done. So these are actually are the rules that are there for any of the portrait or the face side profile. So it's not something that is very different. It is just broke. I broke it into parts so that it's easy for anybody to understand here. Now, jewelry plays a lot of vital role in this, because all the pictures, all the features are there, but the beauty of the whole figure is with lots and lots of jewelry that it is put on. Now, this is one I would want to tell you about, the eyebrow. Eyebrow plays a very important role. This is a, if it is a very high raised eyebrow, we see it prominently in the Mughal paintings. The face is very stiff, nose is very pointed. So that will happen. Here, and we also have Pichhwai in a Kishangarh style. The eye of that Pichhwai will be a little raised. So here, this way. So this is like very high. It goes very high like that. So when we practice, we have to practice a lot of eye shapes. Like this. It will come very easy with a little bit of practice. So here I will just soften this part a little. There is a small thing, we do not connect this to this part. Just take it here and this is. Now this lip also will have a little bit of change. It's not, the lips are not like this. Don't make it like this. The lips are generally, the first one doesn't have much plump. There is a lift in it and then it goes like this. Here the lower portion is like this and there. So the lips are like this. This is the side lip, not like this. So this is a no, and if you want to do this, this is the right way of doing it. Here I've made the line, and yes, the shade work will follow like this. A little shadow cast on the lip. So this is only the drawing part. How to do the a little more work here. So jewelry, whatever jewelry we want to do, generally it is beaded jewelry. A lot of beads are there, and we create that bead effect by adding different shades in different forms. So the pearl effect that we add, bindi can be put or maybe eliminated, your wish. But Rajasthan paintings, they would have this. Otherwise, in Mughal paintings, strictly we do not have. Now, taking the ear, you have to take this part and this part. So from the end of the nose and the eye, here I am doing the ear, double it. This is whatever jewelry, whichever way you want to put the jewelry, you can put that jewelry. This is the way the dupatta goes, and here is some of the hair will be visible. So I'll just roughly give it a shade. So this pencil which I'm using is a woodless graphite, just to put a little bit of shade work. It will be much finer with the final picture. Just giving a little shade. As I showed you how to make the nose a little pointed, take the shade a little over here and then it starts to look pointed. I'm just giving it a little bit of the shade in the areas where to add the jewelry. Here the beads or any of the design can be added. With the paints we can add white pearls, whatever. This is the place where this will go. So this, only this much of the face is visible here for the neck, just this, and whatever jewelry has to be put will be put here. Whichever way you want to do the jewelry, we will do it in the other part. Any questions that you have for this, please ask. So the detailing is with the pencil. You will get to know the form, how to draw it. If in case you want practice, then do it with pencils many times, then start with the brush. With the brush, if you take, you have to take a very pointed brush, and with a black ink you can try making those pictures. If in case it all falls in place nicely, you can switch yourself to the any feature that you want me to repeat, please let me know, or else you can visit it again. This will be available. Which is the next all? If we don't have graphite pencil. Lata, all the pencils are graphite pencils. There could be a chance that you don't have a charcoal pencil. But all the pencils, even if the school pencils, they are all the graphite pencils. The difference between graphite pencil is that you will have this as gray. This will shine gray. So even if I'm doing this, with light, I don't know. Yeah, it is shining gray. Whereas if you don't have this graphite rod, then you can just do it with the pencil. The charcoal is a different thing. Charcoal pencils will be like this. Charcoal pencils are like this. They are black, jet black. Whereas if you see this, this is gray. You will have this in the, maybe the screen supports it. Let's see. Yeah, there's one is gray and one is black. So that is all the pencils, all the even the school going pencil, the writing pencil is a graphite pencil. You can use that. Anybody has any questions can type in. And I will shift this page and start with a full figure now. So practice more and more faces. If in case how we do the male face or the female face, it is almost the same. Only a little bit of the eyebrow will change. Here we can also add the details like maybe a nose pin or a nose ring. This is very common. Nath is very common in this. So just try to make a perfect circle and the pearls here. Here. Generally it has a drop, the drop pearl here like this, and this becomes the Pichhwai style of jewelry. Here you'll see the pearls, you'll have to shade a little bit of pearl to get it a very fine look. Hello Shalini, hello everyone. Can you repeat the eye, the full eye repeat? Okay, quickly I'll just tell. Here, just take the eyelash line. It can have its own fall because eyelids are flexible and open and shut in their own way. This is the eyelash portion. Here I'm giving the tear gland and a nice petal shape. This is a very big one that I'm making. Probably it'll solve your... There is this eyelid. And thereafter, the eyebrow. You can give it the thickness the way you want it. Generally, for the males, we add a little bit more thickness and they are shorter than the females. When we are doing normal herd keepers, then we'll just do it like this. So this is how it will be. I'll just quickly take this big rod because that covers quick. Here. So that is how it's a very rough sketch of the eye. Just giving it a little. This is not the manner we do the realistic eye. It's the line pattern. It's the line work. All of this will be very, very soft when the shading in the Pichhwai will come. So the tear gland is at the corner here. The bigger one will help you to understand. There's some shade in the eye. The white of the eye, and there's a lower lid also, so we'll just shade, not giving it a very high crease, very crisp. And there, this portion will be where the nose will start. I hope that's clear, right? So this is a very small one. Here I've made very big. It's about like my hand size. Okay, and yes, so now we will start on the other part of this. Now, how to do the full figure? First, you have to divide your page into sections. When we do the full figure, the major problem comes that people get carried away in making the face and end up making it bigger. So always plan your picture and... Wait a minute. The full thing is visible. Always plan your picture and wherever you want to make the picture, first of all, you have to see the place. If it is in the center or in the side, you have to see where you are planning to make it. Okay. Now, after that, you have to divide it into normally 7 equal portions. If the head to the toe, 7 or 8, depending. Okay. So 7, 7.5, generally 7, 7.5 and 8. These portions are taken. Okay. So here I'll just start with this here, and I will take the size of the face which I want. Just whatever, A3 size, A4. I have taken A4 cartridge paper. And here I'll take the one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Taking 7 here. This is the 7 divisions. Roughly, you don't have to really measure it. Okay. The first one, or else I can actually, I thought of moving it up. I won't move it up. It's here. Okay. So whatever is done is done. Here. Now, the head, I want it to tilt a little. And therefore, I'll just take the angle for the face. So this is the angle of my face, a little tilted one. Here. So I'll just erase this. So my first portion is like this. Now, we'll start with the face drawing. As we have done it in detail, now we will do it a little. I'll just zoom in a little. Yeah. I hope it's clear, it's not blurry. Yeah, it's fine. Now here, I'll take a pointed pencil. Again, divide it into 3 parts. I'm not doing it now because I can do it directly. If in case you want to, please divide it into 3 parts. And then the nose. This. So I've quickly done the outline. So this don't consider as a face study here because I've already shared the face study, but still I'm giving it. Just going very soft, and this is my mechanical pencil, very light. Here for the hair, I'm switching. So this is just a pencil sketch. Here again, as I told you that this will be a curve. This is the place where the dupatta or the orni comes. And here. The neck. Now for the body, we will see that the body will come very straight. So if we say it's not the half, it is the 3/4 profile. And here for this, I'm just taking the center. This is probably the center of the body and the whole figure is here. Take the so first we make the body and then the all the dress will come. because that all the dupatta and everything comes over it, and it is quite transparent, and we see the details of jewelry and other things through the dupatta. So the dress is opaque, but the dupatta is very transparent. So just making the hand. See to it that your face, the face, just the face part, not the head, don't include that. The face part, whatever the proportion is, will be the proportion of your arm here. And the same way the proportion will be here as well. So it is almost the same. The hand, when we draw the hand, we have to be, again, as I said, we break it into shapes, and here I am breaking it into a shape. So this is the angle of the hand, and this is the thumb, and therefore the fingers. Everything is falling in the same shape. These will be the details. I will add the details, the dress, everything will be done after you make the whole body form. That is very, very important. So do not start with making the details. So here I've covered this only with the line showing, only this part is visible. Whereas in this part, now the dupatta and all will be drawn later. We don't draw it right now. See to it that both the arms are of the same size, very important. Give it a soft curve, and here also the same shape. I'm just doing it like this, this shape. So depends, your angle of your hand changes all the time, and you have to decide what shape your hand will be depending on what is being done, what is the again, these will all be, I'll be giving some flowers in the hand here, okay, later. This is the head. You may add a juda or open hair, your wish. Whatever design we'll do, we will see how the dupatta falls on it or the burdi. Shoulder area, how can you decide shoulder area? Okay, I'll just let you know how to decide on the shoulder area. I had a paper here where I was telling you. So, this was the sheet that we were doing, right? For the shoulder area, it's anatomy that comes in. If the face is this much, for the front face I'm telling, if the face is this much, neck goes generally 1/4, and your span of your shoulder is twice as your head. So if you just place your head one here, it will be the shoulder. This is the shoulder. Now, this is actually the play with human anatomy, how your pictures are proportionate. So for that, I guess you will have to go a little deep into the human anatomy. But yes, that is this. Now, when the profile is changing, means the side is changing, the angle will change. And suppose this is the shoulder and this gets half, and this is the bust area. And so this is here what comes as anatomy. So here it can, now this basic form can change into any modern, Indian, Western, anything. This is the human anatomy, and all of it function in the same way. So this is the head, which is one unit, and the shoulder is basically, if it comes in the center here, this is one unit and this is the other unit. So one unit head and shoulders take two units. So that is the proportion of it. Okay, Vaishali, missed a lot of the class today. Don't worry. Don't worry. We just did this, the basic rules and how to make the face, because definitely when we are making this big figure, then the face will go very small and you won't be able to see much details. And I'm not doing much details here. I showed the details on this paper. How to make the eyes and what is the formation of the lips. And yes, now something came up as the shoulder proportion. So that's it. She is looking sad. Don't worry. The shades will make her look happy. Okay. So the shades have to come. Okay. The line work doesn't show much. The shades, when you smile, it's only that the shades go a little. We'll do it and it will smile. Don't worry. Okay. Can we just shoulder? Okay. Anybody has any other question, please type in. I'll take it. Here. Now, after this. This is the waist. And I will give it a... The lehenga takes a good flow in here. So, the lehenga is taking the flow. And the front doesn't take, actually. The front is much flatter than the back because of the fact that the body is more curvier at the back. So this. And here it will fall in straight. Definitely it will have a bounce because there's too much of a gathering in it. So not much. You can actually extend it more. If in case the figure is in motion. Motion means if Krishna's figure is dancing and all, then you will have flares of dupatta going left and right, and even the frill of the dress or the dress will take a little wider span. Else, just simple here. So this is how it is, and now I will be doing the dupatta. Now with this, how to take the dupatta? It's just like the blouse and the ghagra, no more detailing. I'll just take the detailing now. So add the jewels, because jewels will be added first and then the dupatta. This is the drawing part of the figure. The coloring is very, very detailed also, and looks like Banethani. Yes, it does. Here, now when we do the beads, see to it that your beads are of the same shape, same size also, and same. Now, if just this highlight is given, it comes very lively. Okay, these pearls, they shine out. Making the pearls, there's one more thing where when you're making a pearl, you have to be careful. Do not make your pearls like this. Don't make it like this. Okay? It's mostly people say it is correct, but not. It will look very realistic when you just take a you press your pencil and you lift it on one side. So you will have one circular thing, but then your lines are getting deeper at one place and then lighter at the other. So while you are using your pencil also, this press and release works. And this is just a very soft shade that will come on your pearls. I'm showing it to you in this bigger picture so that it is more understandable. And here, like this. So my picture is very small here, so I'm just taking a 0.5 pencil. I have done a long back, I did one frame where I did Krishna and Radha also. I will be showing you. So here I'm just giving it the details of the the sari here. So this all will come over here, taking the resting on this, and all the border. I'll just take the border over it, and this gets a. So this is the place where the border comes. Border is opaque because border will be painted generally yellow or golden. And then here, this side, this is the hair. And this is the place where the it's coming like this. It will come over the jewelry, don't mind that. Later you can just erase that part. Now this, the transparent line is coming over here. This is all the transparent dupatta that will go down. And here, this takes a fall. This. And here you will have folds and the whole of it will get covered. Now this part, this border has come here and the dupatta falls all the way, it goes here because it has been tucked here. So this is one style where we see these are the pleats of the lehenga, the frill of the lehenga. Just give it a little So this is the dress form, how to put the dress. Now there's no need to erase what is showing up until and unless those are your markings. Like suppose I had the center marking which I marked for the body. So I'll be erasing only that. All the straight lines or markings which you have done, we will not be erasing this line because this is a transparency. Now this is the border of the lehenga. Now we will see that the border of lehenga is also visible, then there will be some folds. We will just create it with the pencil. And before doing these lines, whatever jewelry part you want to do, you must do. I will show you the design on the of the dress. Just add to your desire whichever way you want to do the flowers, right? Even for the hand, we have to do the shade work. When we do it in the painting, it is the lower part has to be lighter and the darker. I'll create few effects here. to show you. Before that, we'll give it a little detailing. Here, the Pichhwai takes a lot of time in making because it's not a very quick thing that we can do. It'll take lots and lots of time. Making one pichhwai goes for months and months. Now, whenever we make the details, we just do the drawing of the jewelry first, and then later on we will go with the dupatta. I'll just show you a few places. Here, just adding the dark. And now the lines or the falls or the folds of it will come. Here, we'll just do the I'm just darkening what I made in rough. Just giving the lower lip. Now the beads all will be showing from this, through this. So it's coming with the curve of the dress, curve of the body, in fact. Like this. Now these can be this, these will go from a distance, these designs won't be much visible, so we have to create some kind of effect. I'll just give you the effects of it. You can have your own design to go on this. Okay, I'm just doing a little. Some design, whichever design you want to, you can just make it. I'm just doing very rough design here, just to give you the feel of this is the border. Now, the dress will also have its own fall, and they will go all the way here. Here it's very sharp. Definitely this is lighter because it is covered with the dupatta, and the dupatta flows. So there's a lot of overlap of the dress, which is seen beautifully through the layers of this transparent orni. Now, for only this part of the lehenga, definitely the border is opaque. So wherever the border is opaque, I'm not adding that. The cross lines are erased. Any design. So it's a flower, it's called three petal flower. So here, small motifs. You will have to change the right hand, the thumb and the little finger on the wrong side. Vaishali, what happened? Where is the right hand? No. If the hand is twisted up like this, this is my right hand. If the hand is twisted up like this, it will look the same. It's not necessary that the hand is facing down. If you're holding something, it is up. And that is the thumb, right? Now all these lines are coming. Now I'll take a blending stub. Now this is only the part of the lehenga that is having this motif and nowhere else. So this and this dupatta is having only the dot. So these things will have to be considered. The overlaying and then what design is going everywhere. So here is a pattern which is showing the pattern from behind also, and it is also showing the pattern of the dupatta or the orni. Yeah. And in one pichhvai there are so many figures, so many. A lot many figures. When you add the pattern to this, it gets separated from the whole thing. Now this is how we get the whole view of it. Now here again, this is the border and it is overlapping. Border, when the border is overlapping, the one which is on the top will only get the will get the line and the other one will not. No, I'm not going to paint it today. So here this is the drawing part and how to do the detailing on this. Later for the painting we will definitely put up a tutorial on that. Now taking a stump or the blending tool. Now jewelry, there is no limit how much ever jewelry you want to put. If you can, if you want some belt or anything on the waist, you can add this. If you want some jewelry, more jewelry like armlets or anything, definitely go ahead with this. Now here, one more thing I'm just adding on the here, how to go about for the foot. So foot, generally when we make, the foot is a wedge shape thing. So this is a wedge shape, right? This is a basic form of how do we do it. Now, how to add this to a normal looking leg, the heel. Definitely there's a curve here, a little bump here, and with the same shape here. This is the front of it, and then your thumb. So this is basic. From the basic shape of a wedge, you can come up with this, and then later on build on your realistic looking leg. Now here I'm going to do the same, the angle a little angled, here. This is one over here, and this is the other over here. It's when it is in the ghagra or anything, or any dress which is covering the till the end, till the ankle, only little portion will be seen. So if you are making really big legs, it will not look, the foot is showing the full, then it doesn't look so good. Here. Now, which leg is front and which leg is back, you have to see whether the left is back or the left is front. This is the general shape that I showed you. Considering this is, I'll show you a different. I'm making the thumb over here, and then later I'll just make the fingers. Give it the angle. Now you can decorate it. Generally there is a color that they put for the foot here. Alta or Mahavar. In Rajasthan we call it Mahavar. In Kolkata we call it Alta. But this is a feature that we see in most of them. So these are all regional things considered to be like according to your tradition. And lot of color is applied for the foot of the lady. Now you can actually make the nails depend on how much detail work you want. If it's a very big one, for me it is not very big, so that's why we cannot go on a lot of details. It has to be inwards. Okay, let me check. Okay, that you want to say. Just this has to come. So this portion will just come in the front. And yes, the stems will go on the other side, here also and here also. So this is the picture here. And I'll just add a little bit of shade to give it more value. We'll definitely do one in color and share. These are the blending stumps. You get it everywhere in the art shop, like or any of the stationery shop, you'll get it. So this is only for blending a little smoother effect. The lines are very harsh. You can actually use it. Ideal to give the shade in the dress. So so the folds will come a little more real. Now for the neck also, this place will have a little bit of shade. Now I'm just giving a light shade to the face. This is actually the picture, and you can add many like this. So here you can actually make many, many like this. In Pichhwai art, we have different types of postures also. They are sitting, they are standing, they are with the cows, they are in the pond, they can do or they are dancing. There will be a lot many things, and this is only the sketch part of it that I have showed you. Definitely the coloring is very, very extensive, and not even the shading part is full. I would say it has a lot many details that are covered in this. Long back I did a painting which was of Radha and Krishna. I'll just show you the detail effect, and all the dressing is almost the same. There is no dressing change. So the beaded necklace and everything can go a little less or more. So here I have one which I will show you. I'm here. So this was done long, long back. I don't remember when actually. So here you will see how the with fine details, and this is a A3 size or bigger picture. So here with this picture, probably you will get the idea of how the detailing part is. You will, the flowers, the jewelry part, I cannot really zoom it. So if you see the jewelry part here, you will see the gold jewelry, the pearl jewelry, everything is very meticulously done. And it took me around 4-5 days to finish this work. So even for the size of the pearls, the minute details, it's like a 0.7 that I used for this pencil, and there are a lot many details in this. The proportions of the body, you will see that the head size, then the same thing is the bust, where the bust is, then the same thing goes till the navel, then the leg. So all of it will go down. So all the details, you can just go extensively to do it. It's not done in one day or for this workshop. It was done long back because I had a fondness for the detailed work. So this was, and similar kind of picture we did it today. But you will see a lot many changes in different art forms. But the anatomy, the way, these are very fluid, I would say. Fluid in the sense they are very, very beautiful, and they have a very close to realistic. This is only a pencil work that I did. And this is just, I would say it's not, it's just a line work. So many of the shading, like definitely the hand will have a shade over here. There is a small cast of shade where the beads are. This lower hand over here will have a darker shade. So these values will come slowly when you'll study the art form also. And not actually the art form, you can actually study how to form the figures and how to do the detailing part. So that is another thing. But yes, in Pichhwai we make a lot of figures and mostly they are like that. So going to the face again, the face will be like this only in the side profile. We don't see the front face. When we see the front face, it is generally for only Shrinathji. So the picture of Shrinathji which we have done already. Can you post this Radha Krishna picture? Okay, it will be there on my Instagram. Please visit it. And anybody has any questions, you can please type in. And if in case you have any queries or special thing you want to take in, how to design the jewelry also, that is very important. All the graphite has come. Can you please see the previous picture? Can we see the previous picture? Yeah, all the pictures, all the recording will be there in the Arthral Studio channel. You can just rewind and see. Anybody has... Okay. Thank you everyone for sharing your time with me. I hope I helped you with few of the basics that should be kept in mind while drawing the Pichhwai figures. So, yeah, be creative and draw your own pictures, making them in different forms. And... postures, I would say. We will continue to do this tomorrow itself. Okay, thank you. Thank for being here. And I hope you all have subscribed. If not, keep yourself subscribed. And you can also join the Arthral Studio group also. That is on the Facebook. Facebook group is there, Arthral Studio. You can post your works there so that I can see it. And if in case any reviewing or any suggestions are required, I'll give you. And yeah, please don't post your pictures on WhatsApp. WhatsApp groups are there, definitely. If you have any queries, you can call me. I will be available, but sometimes my phone gets really too much loaded with the pictures, with the private classes and with the online YouTube viewing and reverting back. So I'll see you all tomorrow. And yeah, please join me. If you do a work and post it on Instagram, please tag me so that I get to see what work is being done. And if I can help you, I'll be very, very thankful. Okay, see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.